Okay, so what I'd like to do at this point is go under the hood of Raster Calculator and try to show you how this thing works. Just in case you didn't quite see it yesterday, because there was, in lab, because there were kind of so many things that were new in lab, I can understand that. So I'm going to start with this empty egg carton here, this, little 4x4 raster. And I'm gonna kind of fill this one in like you filled in your very first raster. I'm gonna give the cells a zero if they represent locations that don't have parking on campus. And then I'm gonna give them a one if they represent a place on campus that's used for parking. And I'm just kind of making up the numbers here. But I'm hoping that you might be able to follow along by drawing that raster. And so this represents kind of parking on campus. And the other kind of raster we had, it was, I think, the same size and the same extent. So, well, it was the same extent, and the cell size was the same. And so it has kind of four columns and four rows. And this guy looked roughly, I think, not quite like this, but kind of like this, where there were these little squares with unique numbers kind of identifying these zones, and this was our parking zone raster. Is that right? And so then what you did was you took these two and you used raster calculator. To kick out this new one. And the idea is that because the rasters are the exact same size, they have the exact same number of rows and columns, and the cell size is the same, and this corner point is the same in both rasters. So what that allows us to do is for each cell, we can compare the values and perform some kind of an operation based on the values at each location across kind of a stack of layers. Does that make sense? So it's kind of an overlay. We're kind of laying these on top of each other. We're going to compare or work with the numbers that share the same location, just in different layers. And in this case, our operation was multiply. So 0 times 1, 0. 0 times 1, 0. 0 times 2, 0. This guy, 2. What's this guy? What's this guy? What's this guy? This one? Fair enough. Kidding, right? So two, four, threes. So again, just to kind of, I think I've got some tracing paper over here. What we're doing here is that another way to think about this is that this raster here, this top one, here's a big monster pen that allows me to do this quickly. But this thing is essentially acting like kind of a blackout screen, right? So this is like a sh you know, your curtain, with a good blackout layer to it. That's going to kind of hide everything behind it. And it's going to do this for any location that's a zero. And then any location that's a one is essentially going to be like holes that you have in your blackout screen that's going to allow kind of some light or some values to kind of seep through. So if we take this guy and line him up here, that is essentially what we've wound up with, right? So we've been able to kind of, I'm going to call this like apply a, oop, am I below the screen here? Sorry. I'm going to apply a mask, and I'm going to mask out some values and preserve the ones that are outside of that mask. And we're able to kind of do that through the kind of simple math trick of multiplication, all because our rasters share the same extent, cell size, and anchor point. Is that fair? So this is now parking in zones. And so because we're largely performing an operation on values that share a location, right? In the sense that they both have the same location, they're both from this cell. These values are both from this cell, or they're just, that cell is being stored on separate layers, or is that fair? So we usually call this a local operation. Is that still on your screen? Yeah. And so the idea being that raster calculator is part of a family of operations that are going to be called local operations, because local operations do things to values at each location in the raster, but on a location by location basis. It's just basically like you're dropping a pin down, right? And you're doing something to everything that lines up. Is that fair?